Trust me, Kilts. Me money bin alarm. Quick, Duckworth, get the limo.
I shall, get her in gear, sir.
Hurry, Duckworth, hurry!
The pedal is to the metal, Mr. McDuck.
Ugh, not the Beagle Boys again. If they think they can stand between Scrooge McDuck and his 3 cubic acres of cash, they've got another thing coming. Boy.
Yeah, but you better watch out. The Beagle Boys messed with your security system.
Yeah, we've taken over the whole place.
Yeah, me money.
Hey, don't forget about me, Uncle Scrooge.
Eh? Oh, don't worry, lad. I'll save you.
Oh, now that's what I call a stomach ache.
You were hit on the head, you moronic marauder.
Thanks, Uncle Scrooge.
You're welcome, lad. But Huey, what are you doing here?
Well, we saw the Beagle Boys going into the money bin.
We?
Sure. Louie and Dewey are here, too. You better hurry, Uncle Scrooge. They might be in trouble.
Look at the size of this diamond! It's a diamond the size of Mrs. Beagle!
$1 billion, $1 billion, $2 billion.
Sandwich or something?
Let me go, you big old bum!
Not even for an afternoon snack. Big time it troubled me.
Get away from him, you gluttonous goon.
Sorry, Scroogey. Not a chance.
Aye, I did. How you hurt, lad?
Nah, I'm fine. But I saw Louie heading up the stairs with about 1,000 Beagle Boys right behind him.
Stay here. I'll handle this.
Number one by Buck and Doon. $1 billion, $1 billion, $2 billion.
It's a diamond the size of Mrs. Beagle. Hold on, lad. I'll have you free in a jiffy.
Not so fast, McDuck. We're running things around here now.
Cuss me, Kilt. One false move and I'm a roast duck.
Leave Scrooge! It's not worth it!
Nonsense, my boy!
You'll never beat us, Scrooge! Ow!
Woohoo! We almost got them all!
A fat lot of good that'll do us if they make it to me vault! Step away from me fortune, you crook!
Not this time, McDuck! Oh, you ain't getting the drop on this big ol' boy! I'm gonna get you!
Oh, dear. Do be careful or you'll scuff the floor. Safe is securely suspended. There you are, sir. Your safe is securely suspended, sir.
Oh, that's smart.
There you are, sir.
Drop.
Oh dear, do be careful or you'll scuff the floor. Everything's ready, sir.
Oh, my aching head.
Everything's ready, sir.
Curse you, McDuck! This ain't the last you'll see of me!
Eh, good riddance to bad beagles, I say. Now, why in the world was he interested in this old painting? Surely there are more valuable... Well, pluck me pin feathers! It looks like some kind of secret code. Boys! Boys!
What did you find, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, what is it?
I'm not sure, but I know how to find it out. I'll feed it into my supercomputer and use Gyro's new crypto analysis program. Then we'll know what the Beagle Boys were after. Stand back, lads. Brigadoon!
What is it, Uncle Scrooge?
It's a treasure map, lads. And no ordinary treasure by the look of things.
Only Uncle Scrooge would call any kind of treasure ordinary. Look! One of the treasures is in the middle of the Amazon. And there's another one in Transylvania. And one buried 10 miles underground. Hey, wait a minute. Something's screwy. This last treasure can't be right. Yeah, there's no mountain on Earth that's that high. Well, according to the Junior Woodchuck's guidebook, to get there we'd have to take about 537 million steps straight up till we reach the moon. You mean the moon?
It looks that way, lads. Well, what are we waiting for? That treasure's not going to discover itself. Get launch pad on the horn. I'm headed to the Amazon jungle to find the scepter of the Incan king. Thanks for the lift, Launchpad.
No problemo. Lift is one of my favorite principles of aerodynamics. Oh, say, you got your radio, Mr. McD?
Hey, of course I do.
Great! Then I'll be your eyes in the sky.
Oh, I'd be happy if you just keep your eyes on the sky for once. What an airhead.
Hey, I heard that.
Now then, ancient Incan legends claim the king's scepter was locked away in a giant temple of the clouds, and it should be dead ahead.
Gee, Mr. McGee, I see a lot of clouds, but no temple.
You wouldn't, Launchpad. The legend says the temple was hidden away from all but King Manco Capquack himself. But there's bound to be a way to reveal it buried somewhere in this overgrown salad bowl, and I'm not leaving till I find it. Launchpad, I found an ancient coin depicting a nightingale.
Edo, you haven't stumbled across a pizza joint down there, have you, Mr. McNee? I'm getting kind
of
hungry up here.
I'm not even going to dignify that question with a response. Out of my way! Another coin, and this one has an inscription of an eagle. A coin bearing the image of the Queen's horse. It'll help us find the treasure for sure.
How can you tell, boss?
Never doubt the well-honed instincts of an experienced treasure hunter.
If you say so, Mr. McDee.
Treasure! A coin showing the sun. Gads, I nearly tripped over it. This place is a mess. Where's Mrs. Beakley when you need her? How dare you? Look at this! An ancient coin with the image of a scythe. It must represent a good harvest.
This is Launchpad, calling Mr. McDee.
What is it, Launchpad?
I'm running a little low on fuel up here.
Well, where are the extra fuel canisters?
That's why I'm calling you, boss. I checked the glove compartment, but all I found was gloves.
Oh. You'd best find those fuel canisters, or the next thing you'll be flying is a model airplane.
Okay. Last time I ask you for help.
Is that a promise? Up I go! Found another one! And it depicts the ruling might of a spear. Launchpad, what was that?
Plus, I'm sure nobody was using that tree anyway. Except maybe them. And them. And also them.
Look at this one. It shows a shield. You know, I bet those Incans could have minted a whole lot more coins if they hadn't tried to make each one unique. Onward. Look at that luster. Aha! This coin bears an image of the Scales of Justice. Just what I need to help me find the scepter.
You know, Mr. McGee, I had a thought.
Launchpad, why start now and spoil a perfect record?
That's a good question.
Well, I don't have all day. What was your thought?
Come to think of it, I forgot.
Launchpad, were you dropped on your head much as a child? Launchpad, I found something. There's a carving of Manco Capquack on this stone slab, and there's 8 circular notches around it.
Sounds great. Does it tell us how to find the treasure?
Well, I'm not sure what it tells us, but I'm certain it's an important clue. Bless me, bagpipes. These coins I found will fit perfectly into those notches.
Oh, you must have come across an ancient Incan poker table, Mr. McDee. I come down there and you deal me in for a hand.
You come down here and I'll deal you a blow to the head. You're supposed to be keeping an eye out for trouble, remember?
All right, trouble spotting it is.
Launchpad, what if the images on these coins symbolize the various tribes of Manco Capquack's empire? Maybe if I surround him with them. Ugh, no. It's not working.
Hey, maybe you need to say the magic words. Or maybe not.
Will you look at that? The ancient city of Manco Capquack. And that beam of light. It must be pointing to the Temple of the Clouds. But how am I going to get across?
Up here, Mr. McDee.
Beam of light. did it! I found a legendary temple of Manco Capquack.
With a little help from your old pal, Launchpad McQuack.
Oh, of course, Launchpad. I couldn't have done it without you. Now just hold on, and with a little luck, that scepter will be mine in no time. Why are you here, Mrs. Beakley?
I'm just making sure you stick to your diet, Mr. McDuck.
You're worth your weight in gold, Mrs. Beakley. If you'll pardon the expression.
Oh, of course. But I'll find my own way out, thank you very much.
And up. Ooh. Up I go. This diamond. There it is, the king's scepter. Well, oh, this was easier to find than a penny in a parking lot. Catch me, kilts! What was that?
certainly get rich by being foolish.
Mr. McTee, this place has fallen to pieces.
No, I'm not leaving without that scepter. Get us out of here, Launchpad. I cannot believe we came all this way for nothing. What's the meaning of this?
Outsider, our prophecies have long foretold that our ancient city would one day be returned to us. For hundreds of years we have waited, and at last that day has come.
You mean you're not mad at me?
Mad? Quite the contrary, Feathered One. Is there anything we can do to repay you?
Well, now that you mention it, I did come here looking for an ancient scepter. I didn't suppose...
Does it look like this? It fell from the temple.
Oh, they're climbing for nothing. Hey, Mr. McTee?
Bless me, bagpipes, the scepter of the Incan King!
It is yours. Take it and go in peace. After all, it was just the old king's back scratcher.
Scepter of the Incan King. I tell you, boys, there's something special about this treasure.
Really, Uncle Scrooge? Yeah, it just looks like an old back scratcher to us.
You boys need to learn some respect for the finer things in life. Now, if you're done having fun at your old uncle's expense, help me decide where we should go next. Pack your bags, boys. We're off to Transylvania, and we're no coming back without the coin of the Lost Realm. This is it, kids. Draculesti Manor, home of the legendary Drake von Vladstone, heir to the coin of the Lost Realm.
Boy, it's kind of creepy out here, isn't it? Uncle Scrooge, we're not going to break into this guy's house, are we?
Of course not, Louis. This castle has been abandoned for centuries.
Hey, look at this. The Junior Woodchuck Guidebook says Drake von Gladstone was best known by his nickname, Count Dracula Duck.
Is there really a monster in there, Uncle Scrooge?
Ah, don't be silly, Webby. Yeah, there's no such thing as Dracula. Right! He is right, isn't he, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course he is, Louis. Vampires, banshees, and mischievous spirits are just a lot of superstitious hocus-pocus. But you better stick close to me, just in case. Now you boys stay put and keep an eye on Wee Webbergail. I'll be back with the treasure in no time.
Aw, nuts. We want to come with you, Uncle Scrooge.
Don't worry. I'll be back with the coin before you can say E pluribus unum.
E purple bus huum? Yeah, I'm not sure that's as fast as you think it is. Besides, why should we have to stay here just because Webby's a big chicken? Yeah, we're not afraid of whatever's hiding out there, are we?
You boys are so mean. I'll show you who's not afraid of the dark.
Wait, Webby!
Oh, no!
Huey, Dewey, Louie!
Will they be all right, Uncle Scrooge?
Of course. Everything will be fine, my darling. Wait here and I'll be back with the lads lickety-split. Trying to beat me to my treasure, no doubt. But it'll take more than just an old bedsheet and flower dust to frighten off Scrooge McDuck.
Look, Uncle Scrooge, that beagle boy dropped
something. It's an old piece of paper.
Twist me, Tartan. It's an ancient rune.
You mean like a magic spell?
Aye, lad. At least part of one.
Gee, I wonder who tore it into pieces.
We'll worry about that later. Right now, I want you to head to the front door and wait for me. I'll be back once I've found the treasure. Off you go, lad.
Treasure! It's mine! 1 billion 1, 1 billion 2.
Any lunch?
No!
Okay, okay! You don't gotta be all touchy about it. See ya!
That guy gives me the heebie-jeebies. He was starting to look at me like I was lunch.
Well, next time he'll think twice before scrapping with Scrooge McDuck.
Speaking of scraps, he dropped this Uncle Scrooge.
Ah, it looks like another piece of that torn-up sorcery.
Say what?
A magic spell, and it's nearly complete. Just one piece left to find. If only I knew where to start looking.
Well, that bungle boy did say this house has an illusion wall. Do you think he meant...
Of course, a secret passage. Oh, no wonder I've been having so much trouble finding anything around here. Good lad. Now, off you go. I need you to wait at the entrance with the others.
Ha ha!
lost my hat on that one. Is there no end to this madness? Where's the break? Really lost my hat on that one. That's a tough without your army helmet, eh?
Wait till the gang in Sing Sing finds out you were knocked flat by an old guy in his cane.
Thank you, lad.
Yeah? Well, you better be careful where you go poking around, McDuck, or you's gonna have much bigger problems than me. So long.
Now, what do you suppose he meant by that? Ah, it doesn't matter. Quick, lad, see if there's a scrap of paper lying about.
You mean like this one, Uncle Scrooge?
Exactly. This is the last piece of the riddle.
But what to do?
That's what I'm about to find out. Quick, lad, go meet Webby and the others at the entrance. And all of you, stay put. Confounded contraption. Mrs. Bigley, now where did you come from?
Why, from home, of course. I had to be sure you were all right in this filthy place.
Oh, thank you kindly, dear.
Goodbye, Mr. McDuck, and be safe.
Ha-ha! Jackpot! Treasure! Ha-ha! I've never seen a gem like this before. It's a diamond the size of Mrs. Beakley. Well, I guess I must press on. Certainly is greed in you. Watch this. Part of the spell matches the inscriptions on this mirror. Luck of the ducks! I solved the riddle!
What riddle, Uncle Scrooge?
Boys, I thought I told you to stay with Webby.
They did stay with me, Uncle Scrooge. I'm right here. Oh, what a pretty mirror.
Aye, lass. And if I'm right, Using this spell will reveal the foul perpetrator behind all these shenanigans. Magic at the spell. Ugh, I should have known you'd be behind this.
Oh, Scroogey, my old friend, you wouldn't believe how much fun it is watching you run around making a fool of yourself.
What?
Oh, you really don't think you need ancient sorcery to find Coin of Lost Realm, do you? No, I had Beetle Boy's hide paper scraps to throw you off trail.
Why, you sneaky, conniving...
Please, save compliments for garden party.
What garden party?
The one I will throw in celebration when I get home with Lost Coin. So long, fools!
Gee, she isn't very nice. You said it, Webby.
All right, you kids stay here. I'm going to track down that witch and give her a piece of my mind.
Why must you always meddle? That coin is mine! Your mirror and beam spells. It's the last time I shop for spell ingredients at discount store. You haven't seen last of magic of the spell. You may have Coin of Lost Realm, but your number one dime will soon be mine.
Magicka will keep out of our way now, Uncle Scrooge?
It's hard to say, lad. folks like her have a way of popping up at the most inconvenient moments.
Well, when it comes to Magicka, there's no such thing as a convenient moment.
Too true, Louie. Now then, where to next, lads? Find Gyro. Our next stop's Africa and the center of the Earth.
What treasure do you think you'll find there, Uncle Scrooge?
Only the largest gem known to history, the giant diamond of the inner Earth. Aye, lads. This is the place. I can feel all those diamonds singing to me. And it's a right pretty song, too. Gyro, I thought you said this winch was brand new.
It was. It's an unbreakable diamond tether, Mr. McDuck. I made it myself.
So long as you didn't use any of my diamonds to do the job.
Move it, man!
What's all this hullabaloo? Your lunch break isn't for 2 hours yet.
We heard voices down there, Mr. McDuck. Strange, ghostly voices.
Nonsense. There aren't any voices down there.
Whatever you say, Mr. McDuck. But your mine is haunted. You finish digging it.
Ugh, you want anything done, you've got to do it yourself. And believe me, if I hear voices down there, I'll give them a good talking to. Now you stay here, boys. I'm going to get to the bottom of this.
The rock bottom, Mr. McDuck. This mine shaft goes down for miles.
Call a ruby.
This old lift won't budge, Uncle Scrooge. Looks like the key's missing. You don't think the ghost ran off with it, do you?
Look, if I hear one more word about this mine being haunted, I'll start haunting it myself. Oh, I'm telling you kids for the last time. There are no ghosts in this mine.
I don't know about that, Uncle Scrooge. Something must have cut the tether line and broke the winch and scared away those workers.
I'll tell you what scared them away. Overactive imaginations. I'm not about to let a bunch of silly superstitions stand between me and the giant diamond of the inner earth. Now, man the controls and lower away, lads! I've still got it! Why are you here, Mrs. Beakley?
The center of the earth is quite toasty, Mr. McDuck. I wanted to make sure you dressed in layers.
Marvelous job, as usual, Mrs. Beakley.
I'll see myself out, Mr. McDuck. Don't you worry about a thing.
seen a gem like this before. Mrs. Weekly. Madness. Now, what in the world do you suppose those are?
Out of the way! Ouch. Oh, my aching tail feathers!
Boys, Did I not tell you to stay with Gyro?
Well, we,
Oh, I'm disappointed in you lads. It's dangerous down here.
We just wanted to help Uncle Scrooge. Yeah.
Well, it
was... Hush, lads. Did you hear that?
Wackaroonie! Those must be the voices that Miner was talking about.
You boys go back the way you came. This is no place for children.
Yes, Uncle Scrooge.
My way. Look at that luster. Fire one, fire two, fire three. In hanging around here. Once an adventurer, always an adventurer. I've never seen a gem like this before. Up I go. Look at that luster. What's the meaning of all this racket?
Out of the way, stranger. As the king of the Terrafermians, I forbid anyone to interfere with the great games.
Great games?
Stand back. You'll interfere with the Rowl.
Ooh.
Strange creature, you are disqualified. Yes, you're disqualified for unsportsmanlike conduct and roll and crash interference.
Now, see here. I own this mine. And I won't be bossed around by an overblown fuzzball. Step aside, I've got work to do.
Oh, so you're the one causing all the ruckus up above. Well, I have heard enough.
Number one by Back and Doom.
You. can hold up under your assault no longer, stranger. What is it you wish from us?
Well, for starters, stop these infernal games. You're causing earthquakes, scaring off my workers, and ruining my equipment. It's now impossible to mine for diamonds.
Diamonds?
Aye, diamonds. Like this one. Though the particular one I'm after is a fair bit bigger.
Oh, you refer to garbage rocks. We have no use for garbage rocks. They're hard and sharp, and you can't roll on them at all.
You don't say. Tell you what, I'll do you a favor and haul away your garbage rocks free of charge. Just keep the earthquakes to a minimum, all right?
Agreed. I am proud to announce that the Terrafermians hereby welcome your garbage rock mining operation. Here, you can start by getting rid of this one.
Bless me, bagpipes, the giant diamond of the inner earth.
You mean they're wounded and ghosts down there after all?
That's right, Louie. It's as I told you, boys. There's a rational explanation for everything.
Yeah, a whole kingdom of underground creatures who cause earthquakes as part of a game is a completely rational explanation.
Never mind, boys. The point is, we made it back with the giant diamond of the inner earth. And gained an entire diamond mine in the process. Now, where to next, lads? Pack my parka, Duckworth. We're headed for the Himalayas to hunt for the lost crown of Genghis Khan.
Shall I forward your call, sir?
Gee, can I come, Uncle Scrooge? I want to see the pretty Himalayan marmots.
Och, not this time, Wibby, darling. I need you here looking after the boys. Otherwise, who knows what kind of trouble they might get into.
Oh, that's very smart.
Uncle Scrooge!
Indulge me, lads. The last thing this expedition needs is a wee lass about. Ugh, I'm going to have enough trouble looking after the launch pad. Launch pad. I told you to land in the center of the mountain range, not in the center of a mountain.
Gee, Mr. McTee, I thought that crash was rock solid.
The only rocks around here are the ones inside your head. Ugh, we're nowhere near Shadow Pass and the Lost Crown. Now fix this wreck so we can get airborne and step on it, lad. I'm paying you by the hour, and I'll may have you billing me for overtime.
No problem, boss. As long as I have this fuel regulator, we're as good as... Whoopsie-daisy. Oops. My mom always said I was a Butterfingers.
Oh, no. Please tell me you've got another one of those.
Sure I do. But it's back in Duckburg.
Launch pad!
Don't worry, Mr. McDee. I'll climb down and get it.
You'll do no such thing. I'll get it. You stay here and try not to cause any more damage.
Okay, you're the boss.
It's mine!
1,000,000,002. Here now, don't touch that. I need it to fix my plane. Stop! Oh, it's too late. Those bunny bandits have torn it apart. I've got to find those pieces fast.
Oh, no, you don't.
Now to find the other two pieces.
Why didn't I get rich by being foolish?
Yippee! Cuss me, kilts! It's Bubba Duck! Looks like that poor little pea brain got caught in a deep freeze.
What happened? Scrooge! Ooga Ooga! Scrooge saved Bubba!
There, there, little fella. Uncle Scrooge is here to help.
Scrooge saved Bubba! Scrooge saved Bubba! Scrooge saved Bubba! Bubba helped Scrooge! Bubba helped Scrooge forever!
You know, I could use a bit of help smashing away this giant icebox. What do you say, Bubba?
Ooga Ooga!
In that case, follow me, lad! End of the line, Bubba. It's time for you to head to the surface.
Bubba home with Scrooge?
Aye. Launch pad is waiting to take you home to Duckburg. On your way now. It's the second piece of the fuel regulator. One more piece to find and we can get out of this overgrown icebox.
Thank you.
are you here, Mrs. Beagley?
Because you're freezing, Mr. McDuck. This will keep your insides warm and toasty.
You're worth your weight in gold, Mrs. Beagley. If you'll pardon the expression.
Oh, of course. But I'll find my own way out, thank you very much.
Mrs. Beagley. Hey, watch it. Oh, look at the ducks. The last one. Now to get this fuel regulator back to launch pad. I didn't get rich by being foolish. How dare you! There you go, launch pad. Good as new. Now get this bucket of bolts back in the sky.
Just a tick, Mr. McD. This oughta do it. Now there's your problem.
Webigail, what in the world are you doing here?
I wanted to see the pretty crown, Uncle Scrooge.
Oh, great. Now I've got to babysit you and launch pad.
We're ready for liftoff, Mr. McD.
And not a moment too soon. Strap in tight, Webby dear.
Off we go. Nothing but blue skies ahead. Clear as a bell. Not a cloud in sight.
Launch pad, knock off that infernal chatter.
Gee whiz, I was only trying to lighten the mood.
If anything, we need to lighten the plane. Feels like she's lost maneuverability with all the unexpected cargo we seem to have picked up.
No worries, Mr. McD. I've got the coordinates for Shadow Pass locked in. We'll be there lickety-split.
More like lickety-splat.
Glomgold.
Nice to see you, McDuck. Especially since you've led me right to the treasure. To whom do I owe my thanks? Your idiotic pilot. Or did you play it safe and let those two wee ones fly the plane?
You dirty cheat! Only you could sink so low!
And at 15,000 feet, no less.
Complain all you like. The lost crown of Genghis Khan will look right at home on my feathered noggin. Wouldn't you say, Scroogey?
That's what you think. You'll never beat us to Shadow Pass.
So, the crown is in Shadow Pass, eh? Thanks for telling me.
Launch pad!
Come on, boys! One old duck with a cane shouldn't be any trouble to take down! Ouch! Knock it off, McDuck! Here comes a 10 megaton finder's fee, McDuck! Hurry, you fools! He's catching up! Turn a profit on this, McDuck! You haven't seen the last of me, McDuck!
Take that, you big old meanie! We sure showed him that cheaters never cheat and winners never win, didn't we?
Try it the other way around and I couldn't agree more, Webby. Pickle me, pin feathers, there it is. Shadow pass directly ahead. Take us down, Launchpad. Slow and steady this time.
No problemo, Mr. McD.
We're close to that treasure now. I can almost smell it.
Wasn't me.
Then what was it?
That definitely wasn't me.
Whatever it is, it won't last long if it tries to get between me and the Lost Crown.
Uncle Scrooge, don't go.
Don't worry, lassie. Whatever's in that cave is no match for your Uncle Scrooge. I earn my fortune by being smarter than the smarties and tougher than the toughies. If anything's in there, it'd better step aside.
But I'm scared.
Stay with Launchpad. He'll take good care of you.
Stay with Launchpad? Gee, now I'm extra scared.
Did you get rich by being foolish?
Be nice, Uncle Scrooge. That poor fuzzy lady didn't mean any harm, did you, ma'am?
Ma'am? Don't be daft, lass. This monster tried to pummel me. Why, I nearly cashed my last check.
Oh, I know, ma'am. ma'am. But Uncle Scrooge is really nice once you get to know him.
Webby, you understand this creature?
Of course, Uncle Scrooge. It's all in a Junior Woodchuck guidebook.
What's she saying now?
She says she's sorry if she hurt you. She's just upset because she stepped on a thorn and can't get it out.
A thorn? You don't suppose... Here's your thorn, Webbigail. The lost crown of Genghis Khan.
The pretty crown. You found it.
Aye, the poor creature was standing on it. Webby, I cannot thank you enough. I hope you can find it in your heart to forgive me. Without your help, we never would have found the treasure. Oh, and thanks to you too, ma'am.
I think she likes you, Uncle Scrooge.
Yeah, that's odd. Usually it's me the ladies go gaga for.
Aye, well, let's get home before she grows any fonder of me. The lost crown of Genghis Khan is mine, lads. All it took was a bit of tenacity and perseverance.
And a little kindness and patience. Right, Uncle Scrooge?
Right you are, Webby darling. Now, where's Bubba run off to?
Yeah, where is he? He was here a minute ago.
Why don't you answer Bubba?
He's over there having a tea party with Webby's toys.
No, Bubba Smash!
Uh-oh, Webby. Sounds like Bubba's not getting along so good with your Quacky Patch dolls. You keep away from my dolls, mister!
Remember, kindness and patience, Webbigail. Set a good example for the lad. Well then, what treasure shall we look for next? It's a long way to the moon, lads. But the green cheese of longevity will make it worth the trip. Up, up, and away!
Mr. McDuck, I've never been to the moon before.
Well, when it comes to space cadets, Fenton, you're a natural. Now, Gyro, why in blazes are we chewing this awful blue muck?
Why, that's Oxy-Chew, Mr. McDuck. It's my latest invention, oxygen-flavored taffy. 5 good chews and you can breathe on the lunar surface without a spacesuit. Oh, and it tastes great, too.
That, Gyro, is a matter of opinion. Now, which way to the green cheese?
What do you mean? Isn't it all around us?
Yeah? How do you figure?
Everybody knows the whole moon's made of green cheese. Well, that's what my dear mama said.
And it'd take a feather brain like you to believe her. Ugh, sometimes I don't know what I'm gonna... Wait, what's that?
Look, here's someone who could give us directions. Hello?
Ah.
Mr. McDuck! Help! Oh, no! We've got to save him!
Do we really?
We do if you want to find that treasure of yours, Mr. McDuck. Fenton was carrying the Gizmo Duck suit. That's the only thing we've got powerful enough to break into the moon vault.
All right, fine. Stay here and guard the supplies while I look for that bumbling bookkeeper.
Oh, Lillian. I did
me get rich by being foolish. Look at that luster. Why, that looks like the same spaceship that took off with Fenton. Well, I guess this means I'm invited on board. Blast me bagpipes! A piece of Gizmo Duck's suit! Oh, if only I had a way to open this door. Up I go! Fenton, get down from there and stop embarrassing yourself.
Mr. McDuck! Thank goodness you're here! I think those aliens wanted to suck out my brain and make an army of Fenton clones.
Bah, they'd soon learn that one of you is one too many. Now, help me find a security override so we can get to your Gizmo Duck suit.
You mean this?
Security system disengaged.
Fenton, you're a genius!
Gee, Mr. McDuck, do you mean it? Oops.
Warning, damage report. Artificial gravity system is offline.
Fenton, you're a nincompoop. You broke the gravity controls.
Not to worry. I'll have it fixed in a jiffy. I got a level 3 certificate of technology from Happy Ducky University, you know.
Oh, no you don't. You'll probably slam into the self-destruct button, too. I'll get us out of this.
Gravity system restored. All systems normal.
Nice work, Mr. McDuck! Now, let's go get my Gizmo Duck suit!
Not so fast, Dunderhead. You go wait with Gyro. I'll find the Gizmo Duck suit myself. And upward.
Ow, wow, ow!
Hit. I didn't get to be number one, my back and bone.
Four! It's mine!
Up I go. Looks like I found Gizmo Duck's armored suit. It's a good thing Gyro rigged up this hyperspace pocket for me to carry things around in. Now, only two more parts to find and we can break into that moon vault. poor McDuck. Would you look at the size of this diamond? Gizmo Duck's wheel! I've always wondered what Gyro was thinking when he designed this thing. Who fights crime with a unicycle? Now just one more path to find and I can get off this flying monstrosity. Mrs. Beagley, what are you doing here?
I'll not have you risking your life on an empty stomach. No more danger till you eat every last bite.
You're always as good as you were, my dear.
Treasure!
Once an adventurer, always an adventurer. Oh, no, you don't. Gizmo Duck's helmet! Oh, if I didn't know better, I'd swear Fenton actually gets smarter when he wears this thing. Maybe I'm a wee bit too hard on the lad. Now that I've got all three parts, I can head back to Fenton and Gyro. Oh, I hope it's not too late. This old duck still got it. In luck, I managed to find all of Gizmo Duck's suit.
Oh boy, now we could blast into the treasure vault.
Just a moment, Fenton. Gyro, I think I left my favorite $2 bill under the back seat. Would you mind getting it for me?
Sure thing, Mr. McDuck.
Gee, boss, why'd you send Gyro back onto the ship?
So he doesn't find out you're Gizmo Duck when you put on that suit, you dunderhead.
But there are only three of us here, sir. Won't he figure it out anyway when Gizmo Duck appears and I've mysteriously vanished?
I wouldn't worry about that. Gyro may be a brilliant inventor, but his deductive reasoning skills are about as good as yours.
Oh! Hey!
Would you just get on with it?
Say your secret code word and activate that confounded contraption.
Code word? Gee, I can't remember it. Oh, blather and blatherskite, I'm useless. I mean, I'm useful to the extreme. Point me toward the offending blockade so that I might deal justice upon it.
Cut the dramatics, would you, and follow me.
Mr. McDuck? Fenton? Gizmo Duck? Huh. They're gone. And all I could find was this $2 million bill. Oh well, back under the seat it goes.
This is the place. Gyro's calculations said the green cheese of longevity lies just beyond this door.
Step aside, citizen, whilst I blast the door asunder. How was that, Mr. Mc... I mean, well, the path is clear, good sir.
Good work, Gizmo Duck. Now... Ah, Flint-Hat Glumgold. What are you doing here, you pernicious pilferer?
Why, same as you, Scroogey. Trying to corner a new segment of the dairy market.
Why, you... How did you find out about the green cheese?
Wouldn't you like to know? But thanks for saving me the trouble of blasting through that door on my own.
I'll stop him, Mr. McDuck! Halt, evildoer!
No, Gizmo Duck. I need you to help me deal with the... Beagle Boys. Bah!
Number one, my back and doom.
Merry, I made it here first. No, not the cheese. Anything but that. Great Scott! I thought that stuff was supposed to be an anti-aging culture, not an instant growth fungus. Giant moon rat or no giant moon rat, nothing's going to keep this duck from that green cheese and all the green it's going to make me. We did it, boys! All five treasures are mine! boys?
Sorry, McDuck, but your meddlesome nephews are a wee bit tied up at the moment.
Flintheart Glumgold, you put the Beagle Boys up to this.
Guilty as charged, Scroogey. I've been the world's second richest duck long enough. But these treasures will soon change that.
Oh, tell your goons to release my boys.
Not till you fork over that last treasure.
Don't do it, Uncle Scrooge. Don't do it.
The way I see it, McDuck, you're not in much of a position to argue.
Yeah, aye. You drive a hard bargain, Glumgold. Take it, you filthy cheat.
Flintheart Glumgold, the richest duck in the world. How does it feel to be number two, Scroogey?
Magicka dispel!
Oh, it's so rude of me to drop in unannounced.
What are you doing here, Magicka? Quick, somebody sound the alarm! Duckworth, Mrs. Beakley, call the Pentagon! Sell me stock and bonds!
Not so fast, fools.
Wackaroody, Uncle Scrooge! I can't move! Me neither. Now I know how a statue feels.
Greedy old fools. These treasures are far more valuable than money.
And just what do you mean by that?
You find secrets hidden inside old painting, yes? Painting of Drake von Vladstone, also known as Count Dracula Duck. These treasures are part of spells to summon him.
Bah, what rubbish.
You will see. With power of Dracula Duck, under my command, I will rule the world. Unless, you'd rather surrender number one dime, Scrooge. Dime is much gentler way to conquer world. Will save me great deal of trouble. Also, less risk of accidental Dracula bite.
The first dime I ever made? Never.
Then I will take precious nephews instead. You will bring me dime quickly enough after that.
Hey, Dimses are hostages. Find your own.
Quiet, Piggle Boys. Now I take leave. Bring number one dime to my home on Mount Vesuvius in 24 hours, or little nephews will become Snackula for Dracula. Yeah! Oh, dear. Sometimes I still get carried away.
That lousy, no-good so-and-so. I stole those treasures, fair and square.
This is no time for bellyaching, Glumgold. I've got to save those boys.
Pah, forget it. That she-devil's long gone. You can't catch her now.
Maybe you're right, Flinty. That leaves me no choice. How about a deal? You help me get the boys back, and you can keep the five treasures.
Ha! Without your dime, I'll become the richest duck in the world, and you'll be nothing but a shriveled up old has-been.
That dime's not worth 10 cents next to the safety of my boys. Do we have an agreement?
Are you joshing? It's a deal. You know what I think, McDuck? I think you've gone soft. You've let those pesky rugrats become a business liability. And I'm gonna be the richer for it.
Oh, go soak your head. Now remember our deal, Flinty. Help me rescue the lads, and the treasure is yours.
You keep up your end, and I'll keep up mine.
For me money bin. Way through.
Put your back into it, MacDuck!
Hurry up, Grungold. Time is money.
It could be dangerous, MacDuck. You go first.
I didn't get rich by being foolish. I didn't get to be number one by back and down.
Hurry up, I'm growing old! Just not as old as you!
I'm going as fast as I can. It's a diamond the size of Mrs. Beakley. How dare you! It's a priceless ruby. Onward and upward. Gangway coming through. It's gaining interest. I mean speed. Up I go. Onward and upward. Look at that luster. There you go, you old pillow stuffer.
I'm helping like you asked. Quit complaining.
Money magnet.
Age before beauty, Flinty. I didn't get rich by being foolish. Busy duck.
Washed up has beans first, McDuck.
It took you long enough to catch up. What's the matter? Gold bricks in your caboose?
Oh, shut your beak. You're not getting any younger yourself, you old windbag.
Hush! Magicka may not know we're here yet. We don't want to lose the element of surprise.
So... you have decided to deliver Dime after all.
Release my nephews, you evil enchantress.
Oh, not until you show me number one Dime.
Here it is. Now let the boys...
What? It's been great doing business with you, Scroogey.
You too. You've been in cahoots from the beginning.
No, even before beginning. Do you remember who sold your painting in first place? Twas me in disguise, you fool.
Why, you... No wonder it was such a bargain.
$5 painting for you saved expensive treasure hunting expedition for me. And now, at long last, I am ready to use treasures to complete spell.
Enough with the smoke and mirrors routine. You've got my dime. Now release the lads.
Oh, boo-hoo. No time for buyer's remorse from old has-been. Better to stick with master plan. Is much more exciting. I now summon Dracula Duck. Behold! Dracula Duck, I, Magicka Dispel, have summoned you to do my bidding. You must obey my will and mine alone. And my will is that you destroy this meddling old fool. Stop meddling and die like mad. Fight his neck. Plan must not fail. Don't give up, you tower of bat. Careful! Cauldron is very expensive!
ultimate power.
Breath is worse than his bite.
Oh, boys, I'm so glad you're all right.
We knew you'd say that, Uncle Scrooge.
Yeah, we knew you would.
We sure did.
Down that hall, lads. Launch pad will be waiting to take you to safety.
What about you, Uncle Scrooge?
Yeah, the whole place is falling apart.
Magic and Glumgold still have my number one dime, and I'm not leaving without it. You boys get going.
Good luck, Uncle Scrooge.
Good luck, Uncle Scrooge.
Now, give me dime.
Not till you give me those treasures. I want to be filthy, stinking rich.
You already are filthy, stinking rich.
But not as rich as that Chiseler McDuck. Where's the treasure?
No more horseplay. I need that dime.
Oh, no you don't, Missy.
Let go, you fool.
Not till I get that treasure.
Up I go. Onward and upward.
Nice try, Magicka, but I'll be taking my dime with me back to Duckburg. Have a lovely time together. Up I go. My number one dime returned safe and sound.
But Uncle Scrooge, what about the treasure?
Yeah, we had it and we lost it. Sorry, Uncle Scrooge.
Come on now, boys. We may not have got to keep the treasure, but we had the adventure of a lifetime. And best of all, we got to share it together. You, Webbergail, Launchpad.
And Upworth, too. Don't forget about Mrs. Beakley. And Bubba. And Fenton. And Gyro. They helped us, too.
Indeed they did, lads. Now, come on. Let's head for home.
Let go of me, you doddering old deadweight.
Oh, pipe down, you mangy bird.
It was real swell of you to give Glumgold a lift home, Mr. McD.
Aye. I'll put it on your bill, Flinty. You can pay me back in, say 3 to 5 years. With interest, of course.
I'll get you for this, McDuck. Mark my words.
Now, there's a sight I never get tired of. Come on, lads. Let's head to the ice cream shop.
Wahoo!
Hey, can we each get our own cone this time, Uncle Scrooge?
Oh, why not? I'm in a generous mood today. In fact, each of you can even get a cone with ice cream in it.
Every day. Thank you.